Artery blockage test. In today's video, we will be discussing how you can detect plaque in your blood vessels, assess artery blockage, and determine its severity, all by yourself, using a simple test at home. Make sure to watch this entire video for a comprehensive understanding, learn the proper technique, common pitfalls to avoid, and essential measures to take that can help you achieve accurate results. Let's begin. Atherosclerosis starts early in life and has no symptoms until the artery is at least 50% blocked. Patients often seek medical attention late in the disease progression. By that time, significant damage has already occurred. It is important to stay vigilant and check for any signs of blockage. Several methods of screening for artery plaque exist, each with its own set of pros and cons. Even most of screening tests cannot detect the problem at the early stages of the disease process. Fortunately, there are tests you can perform at home to assess your vascular health and check for any arterial blockage. Atherosclerosis primarily affects the coronary arteries of the heart, the carotid arteries in the neck, and the arteries located in the legs. These tests can detect potential problems at an early stage, calling for immediate medical intervention. One of the most common forms of artery blockage occurs in the legs, known as peripheral artery disease, PAD. This condition restricts the blood flow to the legs, causing pain and discomfort. Individuals with peripheral artery disease, PAD, face an increased likelihood of developing coronary artery disease and cerebrovascular disease, potentially resulting in a heart attack or stroke. To determine plaque buildup and arterial blockage, measuring the severity of peripheral artery disease in the legs is an effective method. This is done through the ankle brachial pressure index measurement, which compares the blood pressure in your ankle to your arm. Healthy blood vessels allow for easy blood flow, similar to a smooth pipe. However, in atherosclerosis, inflammation causes fats to attach to the artery wall, forming hardened plaques that narrow the vessel. Comparatively, blood flow in the affected vessel is restricted, while a healthy vessel allows unimpeded flow. In peripheral vascular disease, atherosclerosis affects the femoral arteries, reducing blood flow to the lower limbs. Therefore, blood pressure taken in the ankle is lower than that recorded in the arm. To assess its severity, we use the ankle brachial pressure index, ABPI. Results are interpreted by taking the average systolic blood pressure in the arm and ankle. Method. Get an automatic blood pressure monitor. Lie down straight in bed for 10 minutes. Take 3 measurements of blood pressure in your arm. Calculate the mean systolic blood pressure in the arm. Now take 3 readings of blood pressure in the ankle and take the mean systolic value of those 3 readings. Better get someone else to take the blood pressure readings for you. Interpretation of the test results. By comparing blood pressure readings from the ankle and brachial arteries, we calculate a ratio. The ratio between 1 and 1.3 is normal. A ratio of 1 is acceptable. A ratio of 0.8 to 0.9 indicates a mild disease. A ratio of 0.5 to 0.8 is a moderate disease. A ratio of less than 0.5 is a severe disease. This indicates critical ischemia or blockage. You should see a specialist urgently. If you are finding this information helpful so far, please like, share, and subscribe for more health-related content. Feel free to ask any questions you have. Now back to the topic. When the ankle brachial pressure index, ABPI, is less than 0.5, the patient is at a greater risk of developing necrosis or death of the tissue in the lower limb, and subsequently amputation. In general, lower ankle pressure relative to brachial pressure signifies a more severe disease. Inaccurate readings and interpretations can be made in the following instances. 1. The direction of the tubing of the blood pressure monitor is not toward the head. 2. Person is not lying supine. 3. For accurate pressure measurement, it is important to position the lower limb at the level of the heart. If the leg is raised above the heart level, the blood pressure may be underestimated, and vice versa. 4. Person has not been resting for at least 10 minutes. 5. Diabetic patients commonly have advanced calcification in the peripheral arteries, which is worsened by other factors like smoking and high blood pressure, etc. Severe calcification leads to rigid arterial walls, affecting accurate blood pressure measurement at the ankle. In such cases, when ABPI is more than 1.3, alternative techniques such as toe pressures or the pull test are recommended and used by the doctors. 6. Using a cuff that is too small can result in falsely high readings. Ensure the cuff wraps around each limb within the marked range finder. 7. Inaccuracies in any or all of the pressures measured can occur at several stages, so care must be taken to minimize errors. 8. If you have a normal ankle brachial pressure index, ABPI, but have symptoms of claudication, an exercise test can be conducted by your doctor, which falls beyond the scope of this video. If you have symptoms such as pain, cramping, numbness, or fatigue in the leg muscles while walking or engaging in physical activities, it is vital to have a discussion about these symptoms with your doctor. Medical professionals can perform a variety of tests to diagnose peripheral artery disease and determine the most appropriate treatment plan tailored to your specific condition. Monitoring your cholesterol levels can also provide information about your risk of developing atherosclerosis, which involves the accumulation of plaque and blockage in arteries. Interestingly enough, the type of cholesterol routinely measured and demonized by the healthcare industry is not enough to determine the risk for cardiovascular disease. More on this in the upcoming videos. Post any questions or comments in the comment box below. If you enjoy DIY heart health check videos, we have more in store for you. Check out these videos for further insights and tips. Happy watching!